exercises done in succession. There's a training squat or a flatfoot squat that I really want to teach exercise. And it's great for training all degrees of freedom. It builds cardiovascular endurance, it builds power, it builds stamina.
Within FlowFit, you have the opportunity to really fine-tune your body as a machine, and one of the most important components being spinal alignment and learning how to move your hips and shoulders and all your distal joints around a stable spine. And I think that that is something that not a lot of other programming holds true. I think if you really study all of the CST literature and the philosophy behind it, it's doing it well before you do it more or harder or faster.
The 6 degrees of freedom are not complicated. It's simply a way to describe movement patterns. The first 3 degrees of freedom are heave, surge, and sway. Those are used to describe how the body moves in space. So for heaving, picture a squat moving up and down from the starting point. For surge, that's imagine a forward lunge, surging forward and back, moving forward and back relative to your starting point. And then sway is simply moving from right to left, so moving laterally.
The last three are pitch, roll, and yaw, and I think of these more in terms of how a fighter jump would move. So you're not limited to ground contact. So pitch would be somersaulting forward or back. Roll or tilt would be laterally, side to side, and you roll side to side, so imagine like a cartwheel. And yaw is more of a rotary pattern where you're able to corkscrew in space up or down. It's a fantastic process. It's humbling because it's harder than I expected. I began with what RMAX provides, which is a templated, very generic, but very precise way of training for 12 weeks for FlowFit. But beyond that, I found that with my own body needs, I was recovering from some personal injuries and having children, and I actually hired Summer, who prepared a customized, periodized program that took me through at least 3, I think, if not 4 months of very intensive FlowFit style training. And it was literally conditioning the FlowFit components, so using each of the 7 exercises as a conditioning drill, doing multiple reps within each round rather than just flying through one rep around, and really slowing it down and doing more of what's called a slow flow variation, so that it really enabled me to own the movements and to be very controlled in each segment of each movement until I progressed on to adding speed and a little bit more rotary power to each movement. And by the time the cert came around, I felt bulletproof.
So for somebody that is coming to the certification and wants to pass the physical requirements, just take a breath, relax. Know that you've trained for this and you followed a 3-month training protocol and you have a very vigilant practice. Really pay attention to your breath. Your breathing is going to be critical. There's different levels of breathing, so you can maintain a discipline or a flow level of breath. And be really precise with your movements. Do every single rep and every single exercise with the best possible alignment. Don't slap a break form at all, because that just means like a downward slope. So stay true to form as much as you can. And also, just keep inner core engaged to protect the lower spine during all the exercises as well. Help you with your alignment and posture. It will help you to be efficient with your movement and not let your body down.
Your breath is everything. And don't neglect your breath control in your physical training. So, pay attention to what the different levels of breath control are and find where you are within them, whether it's starting out with kind of your reactivity breath and then moving to a disciplined breath and eventually a flow level. When you're testing, it's very easy to get unhinged from your breath, and once that happens, your fatigue level skyrockets and it's really hard to recover. So maintaining your breath control is everything.
So don't worry, when you go through your FlowFit test, you'll have a coach there that's counting your rounds and also coaching you through if you get lost in exercise. Because sometimes when you get to that higher level of heart rate, you might get a little bit in the zone and lose track of that. Mm-hmm. But you'll have some things.
your rounds so that you don't have to worry about it and you can just focus on the next round. And that is your only round. And once you complete it, recover your breath, focus on the next round, which is your only round.